Hi, good afternoon. HCLTech declared its Q4 results yesterday. Here's a quick review on the same. On the revenue front, the revenues came in marginally ahead of expectation at $1.23 billion. This was a growth of 3.1% quarter-on-quarter in dollar terms, and in constant currency terms, it was 3.9% quarter-on-quarter growth. This was mainly due to the sustained robust performance on our infrastructure business, which grew 9.4% quarter-on-quarter in constant currency terms. On the flip side, the software services business continued its sluggish trend, growing only 0.6% quarter-on-quarter. On a positive note, HCLTech declared multi-year transformational deal wins of value $1 billion plus, further vindicating a strategy of focused integrated approach towards the rebid deals market. Another positive about Q4 results was its broad-based nature across services and verticals. Financial services, telecom, and manufacturing led the growth by 5.8%, 5.9%, and 4.7% Q-on-Q growth respectively. Within services, except enterprise application services, all the other services grew well. The growth of the service line was driven by infrastructure services, by BPO and engineering and R&D services, which grew by 4.4% quarter-on-quarter. Among the clients, the top 5 and top 11 to 20 clients showed decent growth of 3.1% and 7.8% quarter-on-quarter respectively. Also, there has been a noticeable improvement within the client revenue buckets, with $50 million plus and $40 million plus clients improving by 1 and 3 respectively. The Q4 consolidated operating margin for HCLTech was better than expected, expanding 110 basis points as compared to our expectation of only 30 basis point expansion. The beat was on the back of operational efficiency gains as well as rupee depreciation, which more than offset the headwinds from visa cost as well as correction in realization. The Q4 results were strong for HCLTech considering the robust revenue performance, margin beat, broad-based growth and decent deal wins. HCLTech should continue to ride on its well-balanced services portfolio, both discretionary and non-discretionary, and benefit from the ongoing churn in the rebid restructuring deal space. We incorporate the Q4 results and the weaker rupee assumptions into our estimates and continue to maintain our positive stance and buy rating on the company. We have a target price of Rs. 1110 on the stock and upside of 19% from here on. Thank you.